Now I would like to invite Mr. Huan Ryu to present his paper, Determination of Combined Hardening Parameters to Simulate the Formation Behavior of CT Specimen Under Cyclic Loading.
Nice to meet you. I'm Huan Ryu from Korea University, and actually I have to say sorry for the title. Yeah, some people came here for the load parameter, but I changed the title for the presentation, so I'm sorry to I cannot upload the in the program book the title of my presentation. So my presentation title is Determination of Combined Hardening Parameters to Simulate Deformation Behavior of CT Specimen Under Cyclic Loading. Since 1950s, several models were developed for the simulate the cyclic hardening behavior. From the linear kinematic model, nonlinear kinematic model, and then there are many complicated models such as Chaboshev model and Onowan model. And with this very simple model, we can determine the parameter easily, but it has some limitation to simulate the more accuracy. So we use, in this study, we use Chaboshev model for the cyclic hardening parameter. And we want to use this cyclic hardening model to the cracked problem. So for the cracked problem, several researchers published the result and the analysis on the delta J and crack closure and crack tip stress field by using the simple parameter, simple hardening model, or just they determine the parameter with the simple experimental hysteresis loop, and then they and in that researches there are some limitations. They do not validate for the parameter to use for crack problem, and then they use this parameter to the stationary crack simulation. So we need to, we think that we need to show the effect of parameters on the cyclic deformation behavior for cracked component. So this is a test result from the Joseon University. We take the two material, TP316 and CF8A at room temperature, and chemical composition is shown in table. And we conducted the tensile test, monotonic tensile test, and cyclic tensile test. We conduct cyclic tensile test several different strain range of cyclic tensile tests. In the case of TP316, we conduct three different strain ranges for 0.4%, 0.8%, and 1.2%. And CFAA for the more experiment was conducted. And we also conduct some experiment on the cyclic CT test. We use half-T CT specimen, and we applied load like this graph. And when loading sequence, we applied displacement control load, and for between each cycle, we increase the delta, incremental displacement. And unloading step, in the unloading step, we use load control because we have to maintain the load ratio. So this is the result of cyclicity test. First one is cyclicity test, load displacement curve from R ratio, load ratio minus 1.0, and second one is load ratio for minus 0.5. And also we can get from this test, we can get the crack extension displacement curve. And this curve should, will be used importantly in the later. This slide explains about the combined hardening parameters. We use so-called Shaboshi model, combined hardening model. It is consist of isotropic hardening and kinematic hardening. Isotropic hardening is expressed by RP function, and kinematic hardening can be expressed by these three back stress, alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha 3. And gamma 3 is expressed for the ratcheting phenomena. So in this model, we have to determine these nine parameters, combined hardening parameters. For this C1, gamma 1, C2, gamma 2, C3, this is for kinematic hardening parameter. And these parameters can be determined by comparing with the stabilized hysteresis loop. And this gamma 3 is, I said that this gamma 3 is related with ratcheting, so we cannot determine from the hysteresis loop this gamma 3. And Q and B is related with isotropic hardening, and this can be determined by using this, the change of hysteresis loop from first cycle to stabilized cycle. And this is the, this slide explained about the determination procedure for the combined hardening parameters. From the hysteresis loop, experiment hysteresis loop, we can determine the kinematic hardening parameter and isotropic hardening parameters. To get the kinematic hardening parameter, we have to use the stabilized lead line, stabilized hysteresis loop. We move this half stabilized loop to the origin and make half size, and then we transfer to true stress and plastic strain. And then we can get sigma zero yield strength and Q, isotropic hardening Q. And we can, and then we can determine C3 and gamma 1 parameter. C3 is, as you can remember, just C3 parameter is a linear part of back stress. So we can get the C3 parameter from the slope at the peak point, and gamma 1 is determined from literature. And then we can use curve fitting, and then we can determine, finally, we can determine C1, C2, and gamma 2. And for this isotropic hardening, we can determine the, for the each cycle, we can find the sigma zero value, and then we can find the Q value with the difference between first cycle and stabilized cycle. And then B can be also determined by curve fitting. By use this procedure, we use these three different strain range test data. And first one is 0.4, 0.8, 1.2. And then following with the determination procedure, we determined all the parameters summarized in this table. And with the different strain amplitude test data, we have to get the different parameter. So by using this parameter, we can now apply to the correct component. To show you simulate result, I have to explain about debonding option in Abacus. In Abacus, offer us to we can simulate the correct propagation by using this fracture criteria. In Abacus, they offer several type of fracture criteria, such as critical stress, crack opening displacement, crack length versus time criteria. And in this study, we use crack length versus time criteria, and we simulate the crack propagation. And this is the FE mesh and modeling. We did the 2D plane strain, and we use plane strain analysis, and we use second order reduced integration element and large geometry change option. And from the experimental data, Cray extension displacement data, we put this data to the simulation, crack propagation simulation as input data. And then we can simulate for each LLD, we can simulate the crack extension. So finally, we can get the load displacement curve. And then we can solely compare the combined hardening parameter can affect to how combined hardening parameter affect to the load displacement response. So this is result of cyclic CT simulation. We use these three parameter set from the 0.4, 0.8, 1.2 strain range, and we just show the peak and valley values for the each cycle. In this case, 0.4 is very far from the experimental data, and 1.2 is quite close to the experimental data. This is why I think about this difference occurred in this result. First graph shows from by using the parameter from the 0.4, I conducted I simulated several different strain range, and it shows different response with the parameter from 1.2%. And this shape of hysteresis loop is affected by this third back stress and this C3 value, linear C3 value. So from this difference in C3 value, there are quite different results from this combined hardening parameter. But in this case, 1.2 parameter is quite close to experiment, but still there is some weak point in the compression part. So in the literature, I found some literature, and in Abacus program, there are some limitation to use isotropic hardening. And in this program, we have to fix the isotropic hardening parameter at all strain range in simulation. But in physical observation, isotropic hardening can be changed depending on the magnitude of strain range. So we have to determine Q and B value for the representative strain range. So I use the reference stress range from R5 code was used as a representative stress so from the difference between cyclic stress strain curve and monotonic stress strain curve, we can determine the effective Q value for this cyclic CT test. So for example, TP316 road ratio -1.0 case, we can find reference strain range as 445, and we can determine the Q value in this case, effective Q value and effective B value. And then we can get the result with the effective isotropic hardening parameter. And as you can see, the effective hardening, isotropic hardening parameter, there are some increase for the tension and decrease in the compression. And after this, we have to determine the gamma 3 ratcheting effect from the parametric study. as increasing ratcheting parameter, the tension in tension part decreasing and in compression part is also decreasing. So we fix the value, gamma 3 value as 10, and then we can find, we can finally determine the Q and B and gamma 3 value. And also we did for different R ratio and different material. And then we find, finally we find that the similar, we can determine the, that can similarly predict the combined hardening behavior in all the load ratio and different material. Yeah, this is conclusion. Yeah. And we did, we determined the parameter for the three different strain range, and we compared with, we compared the result using the debonding option, and we proposed the effective isotropic hardening parameter, and then we use this parameter, we will more study about the crack closure or delta J or crack tip stress field. Yeah, this is all of my presentation. Thank you for listening.